Hello and welcome to this video. In this video, I'll be giving you a demonstration of updated Excel VBA prepayment model. As you know, in our course, we have learned how to create formula-based model, Power Query pivot table model, and Excel VBA model. Now, on all these models, the main engine behind the entire model calculation is formulas. Now, this will remain same in this model as well. But if you remember, in Excel VBA model, we had this summary and we had a lot of features like adding new sheet. I have made some updates. The reason why I did that, because recently I have downloaded these templates and just playing around with them and found some errors. That was due to the worksheet.calculate enable events, which is automatically calculating everything. So that I have changed and I'll show you in the background. So this is our VBA code module, VBE, and as you can see, if I go to any sheet, so example prepaid health insurance, this was the old macro enable event which was working, which was worksheet underscore calculate. That has been changed to worksheet underscore change. So that is more efficient way to work with the VBA coding here in the entire model, and it will increase the speed. So unnecessary steps were repeated in the earlier code when I used this one, but now it is working just fine, especially while adding new sheet. If you download the existing workbook, Excel VBA model, and try to add new sheet, you might face some issue, especially when you're using newer version of Excel, like from 2016 and 19 on even Office 365 version. That's the reason I have made this update to this particular model, Excel VBA model. Now, what has changed? So as I showed you already, the change event code has been changed in each sheet, as you can see. And the older code I have disabled. You can still use it for some other VBA macro or any other application you want to use. So I have kept it as it is. Now, also the drop down menu has changed. It was earlier combo box from Active Control X, as you can see. Right now there is a protection here, but you can insert an Active Control X drop down, which was there already. Now I have changed it to a simple drop down. That has made this code more efficient, entire working of this entire sheet more efficient. And also, the add new sheet button has changed to Active Control X button, as you can see. And also I made some coding changes in the summary. So now all these rows will be automatically hidden whenever you add new sheet. So I'll show you in a minute. So let's go and add new sheet. And before you do that, just see this summary. There are only four sheets summary here, as you can see. 1, 2, 3, 4. And let me add new sheet, and I will go to any sheet. And as you know, you can go to any sheet and add new sheet. So I'll go to this business visa sheet and add a new sheet. So I would name it prepaid land rentals. And the new sheet has been added, prepaid land rentals, and the name also been changed here. And now let's go back to summary and update the summary. Now I want to see for 2019. So this is most important. Before you click this update summary button, you need to change the year for which you want to see summary. So I want to see for 2019, and now I'll click update summary. As you can see, you will only see the rows which has data. So that's the new macro I've added. So prepaid land rental has been added, which was not there before. So this is working dynamically, and whenever you delete any sheet, it will automatically change and it will reduce the row here. So if you want to see that, I'll show you. So before I do that, I need to disable the workbook protection. So let me disable that and let me delete this. Delete, go to summary and update summary. You see, that particular row for prepaid land rental has been gone. So this is the change, and the macro for is very simple. It is very useful macro actually. So let me show you how it is working. So this is the macro. It's called summary hide entire row. So first of all, you need to disable the screen updating, and then you deem the range as a range, work range as a range. Now we're going to set the range for our hiding. So for this, the range is summary list. So basically this is the range. Let me manually unhide it. No, I have to unprotect the sheet. So let me and hide it. So this is our complete range for the summary. So we are assuming we're going to have this number of prepaid sheets just for this model. So you can have more or less, it's up to you. But if you go here in the name ranges and select summary sheet, so this is the name range I have defined. So basically it sets this particular range and then see that any value is there in the sheet. So any value is here in this particular area, that is in B, column B. So entire this range, if there is something in any cell, it will not hide it. Otherwise it will hide it. So that's the rule here. So basically we don't have anything here till end, till total, total prepayment row, row 49. That's why it is hiding automatically. So whenever you have something here, so basically when you go to our original macro of create update sheet, this create index summary, I have put this code here called summary hide. So after it paste everything, so basically this code starts with unprotecting the entire workbook because we cannot copy anything unless it's unprotected. And then first thing it does, it selects the summary sheet and I have put this macro called rows entire row hidden false. So basically when you update, these rows already hidden, so we need to unhide them, otherwise the copying will be completely wrong, it will copy over the total prepayment, right? So we need to unhide it, and then the whole macro runs to copy individual prepayment balances from each sheet. And then at the end I'm calling this macro called summary hide row, which is here, which basically selects this row and hides all the rows which doesn't have anything. So it selects entire range like this, summary list, this range which you have defined as a name range, which is row B5 till B49. That is our name range. It's easier to reference in the macro, so I have defined a name range. And it goes through all these rows and wherever there is nothing, it hides it. So if you see the code again, I'm putting zero. If the range value is zero, it hides it. And in Excel, zero means nothing anyway. So if you put zero, it will assume that there is nothing here. So it is this empty is equal to zero basically in Excel. So that will hide it in the entire this particular selection. So this is the change I have done in the macro, and also as I told you, the new button and also overall engine performance of entire model is working more efficiently than before. So let me know if you have any question regarding this new workbook. As I told you, this workbook will be available for download in the resources section. You can download it and try it with your own application. And if you have any question, as usual, let me know. I would love to help you out. And you have my email ID as well, which is prashant@exitprobi.org. And do not forget to visit my newly created blog, www.exitprobi.org. The link for the same, so you can see down here, the exit URL. So thank you very much, and I'll be releasing more videos soon on my YouTube channel as well. For the link for the same is in my public profile, and you can always search ExitProBI on Google to find my YouTube channel. Thank you so much.